This gentleman who was working at a hospital in New Jersey, Reuven Alonalayoff, excuse me, I pronounced his word, I'm sure I butchered it, because apparently he is responsible for a cache of guns and weaponry that were found in that hospital. Yeah, so this gentleman, Reuven Alonalayoff, is 46 years old of Elmwood Park. He was taken into custody at Newark's Liberty International Airport by Secaucus police with assistance from the US Department of Homeland Security. He was charged with possession of an assault firearm and 2 counts of possession of a high capacity magazine. That's according to the Secaucus police chief. Now the hospital officials, they said this in a statement. The presence of weapons in a hospital is inexcusable beyond comprehension and contradicts our mission of care and our commitment to the safety of our community of staff, patients, and extended community, a Hudson Regional Hospital official said in a statement. While regrettable, this incident has given us occasion to review security protocols and we have taken steps to assure it. So what went down was basically it was responding to a bomb threat. The police swept the hospital and no bombs were found, but a bomb detection canine gave a positive indication on an unlocked closet within an office. Now upon entering the closet, police discovered a large cache of rifles, shotguns, and handguns, along with assorted ammunition from the firearms. That's what Miller said, according to the Jersey Journal. A total of 11 handguns of various calibers and 27 rifles, shotguns were discovered. A Chris Vector 45 caliber semi-automatic rifle with a high capacity magazine was also recovered and determined to be an assault rifle. Additionally, 14 round high capacity handgun magazine also seized. The bomb threat was later determined to be a hoax. Wow. It's interesting how the hoax is why they end up finding out something that was not a hoax at all or not even comical. It's the fact that this man was building an arsenal in a hospital, AB?
Yeah, that's a little scary. I mean, on the one hand, I know we just saw the incident where someone ran up in the hospital looking for the doctor, you know, and shot a couple of people. I get that. But on the other hand, it's like this is a hospital. You know, you have different type of patients. You have mental ill patients. You have children, right? Someone could have easily gotten a hold of those arms and it could have got real ugly in there. I mean, where are we at in the world when people are bringing this many guns into a hospital, and for what reason? Like, this is why we need gun legislation to dictate how people are allowed to bear arms, because this is scary. We don't know if his intentions were to protect himself or if he is deranged and criminal and was ready to get active on whoever he didn't like. This is not okay, and I'm scared about where we are right now with the gun legislation, when people just have ARs and rifles just in the hospital, in a closet, and undetected.
No, yeah, that's my thing. Part of me is like, oh, he was not looking to protect himself in the hospital with that armory. Like, you know, because if he had this at home, I'd still be concerned, but it wouldn't bother me as much as, why are you bringing this to work? Of all the things you could bring to work, why are you trying to bring an armory to work? And you're absolutely right. The fact is that there are so many different people in hospitals. There are children there. There are all sorts of people. And these weapons were not in a safe in any way. They were in a closet. A dog sniffed them. Like, get the hell out of here. What is this individual thinking? I don't know. It's wild. But AB, you are absolutely right to be concerned about people's mental health or actually just people's decision making process, because it is incredibly, incredibly disconcerting. And I really want to know what this individual's motives were and what he thought he was going to do by, you know, again, having this armory inside of a closet at his workplace, which is a hospital. Very weird.